communication by the Commission in relation to allegations of conflict of interest and the theft of public funds by the Marsabit County Senator Mohamed Chute and his wife Lydia Ngode Yusuf. Following increasing media inquiries, the Commission wishes to confirm that Senator Mohamed Saidi Chute is at the Commission for the purpose of a statement recording and interview by investigators. And this is in relation to an ongoing investigation that involves loss of public funds, and the senator is implicated as one of the suspects. The senator is at the Commission after the Commission ordered him to appear before it today. And this is part of an ongoing investigation into allegations of massive corruption at the county government of Marsabit, where companies owned by the senator and his wife have been adversely mentioned. There are two cases in this regard. In the first case, Senator Chute is under investigations for conflict of interest and alleged theft of public funds arising from tenders worth 365 million Kenya shillings that were fraudulently awarded to two companies that the senator owns together with his wife. These two companies are Blue Nile East Africa Limited, and the second company is called Midrock Water Drilling Company Limited. Preliminary investigations by the Commission indicate that part of the money that was paid by the county government of Marsabit to the two companies owned by the senator and his spouse was subsequently channeled to the sitting governor of Marsabit County, and that is Mohamud Ali. In the second case, the senator is linked to embezzlement of public funds, again in fraudulent tenders worth 2 billion Kenya shillings that were awarded to his company called Midrock Water Drilling Company. And this is for the construction of Badasa Dam that is in Marsabit County. That company, which was not in the first place not qualified for the tender award, has since received payments for no services rendered. So the investigation is still ongoing after he finalizes the ongoing process of recording a statement and the interview by detectives. He will be allowed to go and may be required to come again as need arises. I also mentioned that this is one of the cases that ESC is pursuing, focusing on various state officials that are implicated in cases of conflict of interest. ESC has continued to emphasize that conflict of interest is a very big problem, especially in the county government. And that is one of the reasons why ESC is concerned about the conflict of interest bill. Because if we end up with a weak conflict of interest legislation, that means that conflict of interest, which is largely arising and perpetuated in tender awards, will continue. If you look at the suspects that ESC has taken to court so far, including 10 governors, conflict of interest is one of the issues. Former Governor Waititu, together with his wife and daughter, are in court because of conflict of interest. Recently, Mwangi Wa Iria, his two wives and a brother-in-law, in court because of conflict of interest. We have Oparanya, whose charges were approved by the DPP, but he has since obtained orders stopping the prosecution. Again, Governor Oparanya and his wife's conflict of interest. So that tells you that conflict of interest, particularly in procurement, accounts for over 90% of the mega corruption scandals that ESC deals with. And that is why we continue to urge Parliament, we will engage the Senate and the National Assembly to ensure that we can agree on a conflict of interest bill that will effectively address the challenges that we have. That is all. You have a question? Swahili, baada ya maswali mengi kutoka kwa wanahabari kuhusu kuwepo kwa Senator wa Marsabit katika ESCC, ESCC inafafanua kwamba ni kweli Senator wa Marsabit ambaye anaitwa Mohamed Chute yuko hapa, na hiyo ni kwa minajili ya kuandikisha taarifa kuhusu tuhuma za ufisadi ambazo zinachunguzwa. Kuna kesi mbili ambazo Senator huyu anahusishwa nazo, ambapo anahusishwa na mgogano wa maslahi, ile ni conflict of interest, pamoja na ubadhirifu wa pesa za umma. Na hii ni kutokana na kampuni zake mbili ambazo anamiliki pamoja na mkewe. Kampuni hizi zimepewa tender na county government ya Marsabit, na tender hizo thamani yake ni milioni 365. Katika kesi ya pili kuna tenda nyingine ambayo alipewa na shirika la maji kuhusu kuchimbwa kwa bawa ambalo linaitwa Badasa Dam kule Marsabit, kiwango cha bilioni 2 kimetumika pale. Senator huyu kupitia kampuni yake ambayo anamiliki pamoja na bibi yake wanasemekana kwamba licha ya kutotekeleza yale majukumu chini ya tenda hiyo, waliweza kupokea pesa hizi kutoka kwa shirika hili la maji, na ndio maana akaitwa leo ili aandikishe taarifa ili uchunguzi umalizwe. Baada uchunguzi kumalizika, hatua zile ambazo zinatakiwa kufuatwa kisheria ikiwemo kupeleka faili zile kwa mkurugenzi wa mashtaka, basi zitaweza kuchukuliwa. I will also want to clarify that after the investigation, if these allegations are confirmed to be true, besides recommending prosecution, ESCC will file civil suit in court to recover in full any public money that may have been lost or fraudulently acquired by anyone. Thank you. The last one. We have given a very comprehensive statement on that matter, but I wish to add that ESCC remains firmly focused on the execution of its mandate. But again, you have to remember that an effective fight against corruption is not about ESCC alone. ESCC is just one of the many actors that have different responsibilities, and therefore, to ensure that Kenya effectively wins this fight against corruption, to ensure that we mitigate this challenge of corruption, which is one of the issues that are being raised, as he says, we need to strengthen ESCC, we strengthen the ODPP, and strengthen the judiciary, so that we can be able to handle many cases at the same time. One of the reasons why cases take long is due to the capacity gaps in those institutions in terms of a human resource. Secondly, another reason why cases appear to take long, or sometimes cases are lost in court, is due to gaps in the legal frameworks. Somebody was asking earlier, how come some people were convicted in a foreign country? You remember the Israeli company that some of you have talked about, because of bribing Kenyan officials? You realize that the threshold for convicting somebody under the laws of that country is lower than ours. We are working on the case, the threshold is very high. So for you to prove a bribery, which is the case there, for instance, you must show the original documents. We had already given those original documents to that country through a mutual legal assistance. So we are waiting for the documents so that we peruse them and see what we can do about it. Secondly, because those people are accused of bribing Kenyan officials, that is the Israeli company, the people who are convicted there, because they are nationals of that country, are the ones who are supposed to be our witnesses because they are accused of bribing Kenyan officials. So they have already been convicted on the other side. So ESEC would require them to be witnesses against these Kenyan officials who are said to have been bribed. That again presents other dynamics. So we are analyzing the case and the evidence that is available and see what can be pursued so that they can also face justice. So talking about strengthening laws, there are issues that sometimes Kenyans talk about and I've heard people talk about it. This is suspension of persons under investigations. People keep on asking, why is it that so-and-so is in office, yet they have cases? Because the laws have gaps. So we expect Parliament to assist the Commission, particularly using this moment of legal reform, to address the gaps that have made it easier for persons facing cases of theft of public funds to continue holding offices. This idea of exhausting all the avenues of appeal is sometimes inimical to public interest. The CEO gave a very good example. If you are employing somebody to work for you at your home and someone tells you that they are a thief, would you still want to employ them and say that you want them to exhaust legal processes? No. Recently, we advised a cabinet minister, a former cabinet minister for that matter, not to employ somebody because he had a bad case before the DPP. With impunity, Waziri continued to appoint that person. So these are the kind of things that create an impression among Kenyans that ESEC has not done certain things the way they should be done. So strong laws would make it possible to keep corrupt people away from office until they are cleared. And that is why we were concerned about a clause that was deleted. One of the clauses that were deleted by the Senate is a clause that required persons under investigations to step aside until they are cleared. Recently, we attempted to have 6 CEOs suspended through the head of public service. All of them were returned to their offices by the court. Why? Because of the legal gaps that I'm talking about. Therefore, ESEC needs to operate in an appropriate legal environment that makes it easier to handle these issues in an appropriate manner. Finally, in respect to the political attacks that were happening, we have already said that we are not at war with any institution. The CEO has already clarified that we are not at war with the Senate. We will engage them so that we come to an understanding, particularly on the implications of that bill that is under consideration. But ESEC will continue to discharge its mandate and remain faithful to the law only. Those who have my number.